September 11th, 1998, not the September 11th a few years later that everyone remembers, but 3 years prior, September 11th, 1998, I was in a single car accident in a country road in Geneva, New York. The car rolled 4 times. I was ejected from the sunroof. I was called the miracle angel because the car didn't crush me. I had no cuts. I had no broken bones, but I was laying in the field, in essence, for dead for several hours because in the field, when the roll occurred, the battery fell out of the car. So any cars that were passing by wouldn't see the car in the field. And it just so happens, my stepbrother, who worked at the local fire department after that, many years after, was working with someone who was one of the first responders, and he shared with my stepbrother this story, that there's a house on the edge of the farm where that field is, who heard some noise. It was about 10 o'clock at night, and they got up out of bed, looked out the window, didn't see anything because the battery had fallen out during the roll. And so they went back to bed. But then, you know, an hour or so later, they're like, something happened, and they called 911. And by the time the ambulance and the fire people and the police got there, I'd been laying in the field for an hour and a half, roughly. And I don't recall many of it. I was in and out of consciousness, but all I do recall is the bright white moment. So basically, while I'm laying in the field thinking they're going to be there soon, and then time seeming like it was forever, I'm like, holy crap, I'm going to die in this field. Then the next thing that I recognized was I was in the air 20 to 30 feet and I'm looking down and I see someone lying in the field. And I was confused, like, what's this? And I focus in, I see it's me lying in the field. I'm like, what? And then I'm pulled up and it's all bright white light and I'm standing there confused. And I literally see my sisters and my family crying at my funeral. And it brought much sadness to me, and it had me recognizing, like, what's going on here? Like, am I dead? And next thing you know, something or someone came up and put their arm around me, and the fear and confusion went away, and I had total peace that all was perfect. And even though we're in bright white light and I'm standing there, we turn 180 degrees, now I'm facing this door, and this door is huge, and amazing bright white light is coming at me, and we start walking towards the door. Halfway there, I said, stop. This isn't how it was supposed to end. I know you had more for me to accomplish. Send me back. Well, the next memory I have is waking up in intensive care, my arms secured to the bed with massive pain. All I remember is it's tremendously painful to have a respirator breathing while you're conscious. So I was trying to get some attention, and my mind had what's called severe head trauma, so I couldn't think as crisp and clear, and what I found out once they got that out, that I couldn't also speak. So I had to learn to walk and talk again. It wasn't all from scratch, but it took me a while before I was able to speak and communicate properly as well as walk. Long story short, from that, a couple things I've learned that I don't want anyone else to have to go through those particular circumstances to learn similar lessons brings us back to this purpose of the video. Where we're at right now, there's a lot of fear, there's a lot of worry, and there's a lot of concern about health and about dying, which is ironic to me because we as humans, for some strange reason, forget the fact that we are going to die one day. And we don't know when. That's the rub of it. We don't know if it's today, tomorrow, next week, next month, next year, next decade. We don't know that. But what I found is when people are so focused on fear of dying, they forget to live. What does that mean? Well, what it means is I would highly recommend that you do your best to use your discernment to be grounded in the fact that when you can detach from the fear of death, you can get back to being someone who's living your life with purpose, with joy, with adventure, with passion. And that's, to me, what living is all about. Not to be someone who sits in a corner wondering, well, should I do this? Should I do that? Well, you know what? Hey, this is what it feels like is mine to do. Boom, go do it. And start to, instead of suppress your dreams, start to write them down and ask yourself, boy, I know that that's a pretty lofty dream. What are some things that I could think, speak, and do that could get me a step closer to turning that dream into a reality? You know, it's my hypothesis that we live in the most amazing amusement park in the universe, in this human form here on Earth. And it's got a short window. And I say short window, if you die at birth or a week or a month or years, or you die at 110 years old, the journey's brief regardless. I've been there for my mother passing at 52 years old, in 2007. I was there for her last breath, and I was there a couple years later as my father was diagnosed and gone with cancer in 2009 at 56 years old. So I've been there for both of their last breaths. And one thing I recognized is I will be on my deathbed having my last breath probably sooner than I would want. And that could be at 110 years old or anywhere from now until there. But it's quick. It goes very fast. In a neighborhood in Boca Raton, there's a gentleman, Charlie, who lives a few houses from me. And Charlie is amazing. And Charlie is 94 years old. He goes to the pool. Well, when the coronavirus didn't have the pool shut down, he went to the pool every morning, got his workout in. He's the most joyous and happy 94-year-old I've ever met. Still drives, goes, plays bridge, all this fun stuff. So I said, Charlie, I'm 47 years old. Do you remember when you were 47? He's like that. I said, how fast did those years go? He's like, oh man, it goes faster than you can imagine, Tom. Pretty soon you'll be, you know, God willing, at my age, wondering where did the decades go? And that brings us to this meeting. There's a virtual meeting of you and I right here, right now. You're at your best awaits. And I truly believe that. I know that your best awaits. I don't care if you're Michael Jordan. I don't care if you're whomever in the world who's achieved great success. You have much more that you're capable of. I truly feel that none of us as humans truly come close to even is a smidgen of what our true capabilities and possibilities are. So with this crossing of our paths, it's my goal to help share some insights and nuggets and wisdom that I've learned through traveling the world, learning from the best of the best, going to Fiji to stay with Tony Robbins and his wife Sage at their private island, Namali, in Fiji. Spent a week there. I've trained with Brian Tracy and Zig Ziglar and all of my heroes, Joe Vitale, over the years, and then the best marketing minds alive. Pretty much everybody and anybody in the marketing world I've crossed paths with and not only learned from, but have gotten to know and created tremendous results and had some fun conversations with. And the bottom line is, I've learned some things. I've learned some things to help people get from where they are to where they want to be. And a lot of it boils back to clarity. A lot of it boils back to turning it from going down that fear and suppression of your dreams to faith of, you know what, I do have more than I'm capable of. You know what, I'm not going to settle for mediocrity within myself anymore. I'm willing to step up and figure out what's the next thing for me to do that's going to push me out of my comfort zone, that's going to bring some joy, adventure, and passion back into my life, that's going to get me excited and possibly get me a little scared, because this is that big, hairy, audacious goal that I've been pushing down for so long. And now, guess what? Its time has come to be made a reality. So that's what is in store for you. I have simple trainings, but powerful trainings that are waiting for you when you simply enter your name and email below. So go ahead and enter your name and email. You're going to get brought into my world. You're going to gain instant access to some valuable trainings that are brief yet powerful to help connect the dots in your brain to help turning some of these dreams into reality. So enter your name and email. I look forward to getting to know you better very shortly. Until we speak again, make today great.